And James, it's a new year.
It is. A new decade.
It's a new decade, is it? And what are we out doing on the first day of the new decade?
What are we doing?
Adventure shit. Because that's what we do. And I'm so excited about this year. So what are we doing today, James?
Looking for cool stuff.
Well, we had a subscriber that actually sent us a location in the PICACHO Mountains, so we decided to come here today and see what we could find. You know, this year we plan to get a lot more in depth with different locations, pottery shards, what some of the different petroglyphs might possibly mean, about the different cultures, talking about the way that they live, the way that they live their lives. So we're gonna get a lot more in depth this year, and I hope you come along with us because we're gonna have a fascinating journey, aren't we, James?
I think so. I'm looking forward to this year.
And we're gonna be everywhere in 2020, so if you see us out on the trail, make sure you say hi. You know, and one thing that I wanna talk about today, and we get into this quite a bit, is responsibility for locations, right? You know, we don't tell people where they're at. If you want to find any of these locations, you can. It's not that difficult. But what do you do when you get to the trail? What's the trail etiquette, I guess you should say?
One word, respectful. Be respectful. Treat it like you care about it. Don't leave garbage. Don't grab stuff and take it home. You don't need souvenirs. Just take some cool pictures.
You know, James, let's talk about shards. We've been doing a lot of research, and we'll be doing a lot more research about pottery shards coming up. And, you know, a lot of people are like, don't touch that. I don't believe that. I think that's bullshit because you should touch them, right? Mm-hmm. But what should you do after you touch them?
Put it back exactly where you found it. Enjoy it. Experience it, but it should just go back where it was.
You know, a lot of people don't realize that pottery shards are the clues to the civilization that was there. And depending on what year it was made, you can tell if you do the research of what year that was basically built, the trading of the different cultures. It's an unbelievable clue to who lived in those locations.
Yeah, there's actually a lot you can learn about from the pot shards of a location, its culture, all kinds of stuff. It's really neat. And that's one of the many reasons it needs to stay exactly where it was. Not to mention some of that stuff has been there for 1,000 years or more, and who am I to take it home?
You know, what a lot of people don't realize is that the ancients evolved just like we evolved today. So they got better at the skills that they had. So when you see some of the older pottery, you can actually date that because they actually evolved into building better pottery.
Yeah, it's like technological development. So they started with like very rudimentary, primitive clay-making skills, and then it just grows and grows until you get these really, really pristine pieces that have lots of decorations and colors and so forth. It's really cool.
So our rule of thumb is touch it, feel it, put it back. Fair enough?
Absolutely.
I saw one on that point up there, James. You know, what I'm looking at is, so what we're looking for right now is we're looking for encampments. You know, we know that there was ancient encampments here, so we're looking for some type of signs of where the ancients would have been and where they would have camped. And this would be a perfect location for me, James. I don't know about you, but you're kind of out of the wind here between these two mountains.
Yeah, yeah, and this is the flood area for I can't remember what river. But here's some archaic stuff. And then
again, the dots, right?
Yeah, that's definitely out here a lot.
The butterflies or, you know, atlatl.
Yeah, the Hopi say it's butterfly.
I've got to agree with the Hopi on this.
I'm going to go with they've preserved the language the best from what I understand and an understanding of their ancient.
So what we're looking for right now is some type of clearing where there's some type of rock that's in a form, right? So we're looking for something like that.
There'll be like distinct linear rock placements of a foundation, and then there's scratchings, essentially what you could call a square rectangular shape in the ground as well in this area, and that's old encampments and settlements.
And then again, a road also. So if there's a road, it always goes somewhere, right?
It's a rock.
You know, it's funny. It's a rock, I'm sure, but it sure looks like...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's rock,
weird,
though.
It's that weird patina that breaks off.
It breaks off, yeah.
But it looks a lot like pottery.
That'd have been a hell of a shard.
I sure would have. That's the other thing we're always looking for when we start doing this, is you'll start seeing pot shards.
Yeah, yeah.
You'll see pot shards, and you might even see a point or tools. Someone's camped here.
You know, and a lot of times, the ancient's the new, right?
Well, exactly. I mean, that's the thing, exactly.
People don't go through, don't make new roads, you know?
Paths are usually something that's existed for a long, long time, and then we just kind of modernize.
So we've been told there's six locations here, some of them being ancient, I guess I could say, and then others being more modern. But there is a road here that we've come across, so that's always a sign that there's something down here. Yeah. Very few places have never been tracked, right? Most places, somebody somewhere has seen them.
I've never been anywhere that no one else has been. It may have been a while, but there's some glyphs. So I feel like we're getting warmer.
Yeah, definitely.
I feel like we're going in the right direction. There's some up there. Oh, that's a cool sun. It's a big white sun. And there's a web. I don't know what you call that, but it looks it's right ahead of me, that bush, that one single kind of.
Oh, there's a weird little.
Yeah.
Let's get up there and take let's get up there and take a look. See what we've got.
Well, I feel like we're definitely getting warmer here. It's going to be down below us, but this is always a good indicator. Nice petros.
Yeah, here we go.
Oh, there's always that indicator. And here's little etchings leading to a site. Yeah. Circle. Always the circle with the dot in the middle. Oh, neat. I'm gonna find your thing.
Right here. I say that, but. Now I was told that this is the oldest form of petroglyph, is the holes. That's the original man before they actually pecked and scratched. That they actually made holes, and that's the earliest form of petroglyphs known to man. Are these holes that they have dug out, which is pretty incredible.
Get up so high so quick.
Man, isn't that funny?
I didn't even realize I was going up, really.
Well, just like today, is how far we've got without...
Look at this. There's some behind there, too.
But you know, they definitely had...
Oh, the shield? The atlatl symbol, maybe?
Now, that's a different one. Now, see, that looks different than the butterfly style.
That's shield slash... And then there's that thing in the front that's really neat.
Well, you see it here, and that's on the top of that one, and that's up in that corner.
And then there's something I haven't seen before, over past that that face there, that's kind of different.
You know what I'm saying is that you get up and it only takes a second, as we were talking about, and you're pretty high off the floor. And the fact is the valley is pretty flat and you could see for a long, long way. So if you had enemies coming, this would be a perfect vantage point for you to go, okay, you know, we need to get prepared. Because you were never safe out here. You know, you were never safe, whether it be animals or marauding tribes that were after you. Man, they're always somebody wanting to get what you got. Right, James?
Yeah, I mean, definitely.
Look how fast you got off this floor. You see everything. You see a long way. And from what I'm going to tell you, maybe those flat earthers are right, James. It looks flat up here.
I'm not going to sign off. It's not flat. But you can see for a good distance here. That's a beautiful saguaro forest out there.
Well, you can see all the way across to that, which, you know, you're looking at 35 or 40 miles pretty easy.
I think so, yeah, because I mean, you're looking out over there at the other peaks across the valley there. Well, I will say this is a great vantage point for spotting resources, if nothing else. So if you were living out here in this time period that we're talking, you would plan to set things up. What do we call that?
This is an oh shit rock.
That is exactly what that's called. Oh shit.
And I got an oh shit out of that. That's my first oh shit in 2020, James. This cat here, James.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, I love this.
This style is one of my favorites now. These are really cool. And these are in there. There's the cross.
You know, you get enough peyote button in you, James, and you're gonna see some stuff.
Creative.
Oh, look at that one up there. Did we see that?
The ram?
Well, I can't tell what it is.
It's a ram hit with its head down, and then another one going that way. I got a really cool shot of it.
That is beautiful. That is beautiful. Well, there's a mound out there.
Yeah, and that might be it. That, I have a picture of it that we'll have to pull out in a bit here and see what that tells us. Some of this stuff, my eye is not what I should consider trained on identifying all of these types of things.
See, this road comes in the back.
There you go. This is looking promising. This field right here. Something like Harry made it this way.
Now, one thing that we do know, James, is there was a major dig here. From what I understand, it would be farther south.
Yes.
But there was a major dig here. Major ruins.
Yeah, some of the information I got about this place is from the Archaeology Southwest doing a conservancy write-up.
See, this just pops over the top. It just makes so much sense to me for it to be here.
Yeah, no, this adds up to something cool.
Another man up there.
Yeah, there's several man figures. There's a sun. Some of the circles and circles. There's some stuff right here that's interesting. I want to say horned guy. It's kind of bug.
This is such a weird surface. It's so difficult to tell when you get into petroglyphs and when you get just regular, just aware of the rock. They're so identical. That's what's so difficult about this today, is the rock they choose to work on is not that good.
Yeah, this is a really heavily worn area in general, too.
I'm going to see what this gate is up here so we can tell what we're going into or out of.
Dead man.
There's a dead man right there.
Always a dead man somewhere.
And then this flat rock here.
And this might have been what the hunters we met earlier told us about.
Because they did say it wasn't on the mountain.
Yeah. And then it wasn't on the point we were in earlier. So there's some stuff.
Pretty, I mean, still a very interesting place.
Oh, heck yeah.
And we know that there were ancients all along this ridge, all the way from where the eye can see over there, because there's PICACHO Peaks over there, so you're running this ridge line all the way around. And pretty intriguing place. You know, James, I don't know about you, but I see you stripped off your sweatshirt and your coat.
Now I want it back.
And, man, I got cold just like that. And It was like, well, all it took was that little bit of cloud cover, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, that just shows you, when you're out here, you've got to dress in layers, especially this time of the year.
Yeah, because I'm glad I can put a couple of things back on, to be honest.
I mean, the only thing I can do right now is hike a little harder. And that might be what happens.
You don't have any other.
I stripped mine down, but up to this point, I've been sweating. You know what we came down to, James, we didn't find the ruins, but, you know, we found a whole mound up here with a lot more glyphs. Now, we did this lower, but there's some up the top, and before we go back to the truck, I think we ought to at least go up and see if there's anything right up at that point up there. These are really, I love this archaic look.
Yeah, these definitely are supposedly characterized as archaic. Let's go see them. Let's see what we find. Oh, come on.
Yeah, they found some black rock right there.
I like that right there.
Well, you know, you look at that one, and that looks a little different, right? Than that. I mean, this looks different than the rest of them.
Yeah.
You know, it's got more of a... Most of them are free form, and that looks almost like a little more geometry.
Yeah, that's geometrical.
Based.
That's definitely like, appears to be different types of people did that one. As far as later on or a different culture.
One of the better ones that I see is up here.
Well, you can probably get across that face there.
Well, that's what I'm wondering. If
this is a design we haven't seen before.
Kind of a flying V deal. I don't know if Hari got this one or not.
It's almost got that weird, like, atlatl thing going on, butterfly in the middle of it. But this right here is definitely unique from the other places we've been.
That would have been probably a good one there to have some type of D-stretch on.
I would think exactly.
There's a good one right there that probably would have had a lot of, you know, that would have been a nice one if you could see it still. That one, that one there.
Okay.
Guess you gotta like to climb, don't you, James?
Yeah, that definitely is a part of this. Ooh.
Oh, we got a ooh.
Ooh. Yeah, it opens up, man. Careful with that.
There's
one.
A man. As you already said right there, man falling.
So you gotta not. Yeah, if you climb around him, then you get up here.
Get around, man falling. Oh, look at there. That's some.
Yeah,
that's some cool stuff.
And then in this, there's these that are definitely different.
Very unique stuff on this point.
And then there's a snake here.
There was something back there.
Yeah, there's stuff tucked all around.
Well, I just noticed that rock I just went across.
Yeah.
Look at that there.
Yeah, and then it kind of comes this
that
way.
That teepee, there's another. There.
I feel like this would definitely be a camp. At some point, at least one guy was told, stay here and look out.
Well, what a point this would be, actually.
Well, and it's like, I mean, this is where I would camp. I wouldn't even camp down there. I would stay up here. Got a windbreak.
You know, it's funny, James, I don't see anything else on up.
No, it doesn't seem to go up higher. I was going to just take a look because I see so much on the back sides of things. But look at this, it's like a perfect path. This absolutely was utilized, you can tell, for a while because the stuff hasn't been cleared of the loose rock.
They did a lot of stuff on the back of this stuff, too.
Well, that's what makes me think, like, this is absolutely a little out.
Like... You know, one thing I like to do when I'm setting up here, you know, and we're hiking around, and you know, sometimes we talk a lot about the fact that a lot of people don't think, you know, for some reason that there's not like a humanization, I guess you could call it, where you know, were these guys real? And you know, they absolutely were real. And sometimes you want to think that, you know, they were just so primitive, you know. But there's no doubt in my mind that they had all the same hopes and dreams. You know, they had all the same scenarios that we have. And, you know, they had a 2020. They had a 1020, maybe, 10 or 1120. And they were hoping that, you know what, they had good health, and they ate, and the water supply stayed strong, and the warring counterparts weren't coming to get them. And so, you know, you set up on this hill, and you look out, and you take a second, and you just look out. You know, what you realize is that, man, it wasn't a hell of a lot of difference than me and James just here, sitting here looking about, you know, looking at how beautiful this is, and it's still the same beauty as it was when they were here. It's pretty awe-inspiring to get to do this. Sometimes you don't always find all the stuff you're looking at, but the fact that you're out with good friends and good people, and you're blessed with being able to get to do this, and you've got good enough health to be able to do it. You know, some people don't have that good health, so that's why me and James are out here, is to be able to, hey, maybe we're gonna hike for you today. And then if you can, you know, follow some of the trails that we do, because I tell you what, even though, you know, you don't always find what you're looking for, you always find a great day. And I'm truly blessed to have that, and I believe that James feels the same way I do. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna ask him. Hey, James, are you blessed to get to do this?
I absolutely am, man. I'm so grateful to be out here today.
So what?
I love this stuff, man.
You know, what are you hoping for in 2020?
More adventure.
Absolutely. More adventure. And you know what? We appreciate those who've already subscribed. If you haven't, please do. And come along with us. Even if you want to come do this stuff or go to the places we go to, or you can't, you know, either or. Man. Truly blessed to be here, and I hope everybody has a great year. We're going to have an awesome year this year. It's going to kick ass and take names. Cool. Have a great day. Thanks for watching. We do appreciate it.